Right, next one. Sine of trigonometric function. Sine of trigonometric function. Sine is positive, negative. Which quadrant positive of trigonometric ratios? Which quadrant negative of trigonometric ratios? Okay. Quadrants. What is mean quadrants? First of all, O as center. Understand? Yeah, a circle was a center. A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. Here, A, O, B. This area is first quadrant. This area is first quadrant. First quadrant. First quadrant limit is 0 to 5/8. 0 to 5/8. This is first quadrant. A, O, B. This area is first quadrant. Get it? Right. Second quadrant. Second quadrant is called BOC. This area. BOC. This area is second quadrant. This limit is pi by 2 to pi. Next, third quadrant. Third quadrant is COD. This area. Okay? This area limit is, angle limit is pi by 2. This is pi by 2, here pi by 2, here pi, here 3 pi by 2, here 2 pi. 0 and 2 pi. 0 and 2 pi. Okay? Right. Check. First quadrant is 0 to pi by 2, and second quadrant is pi by 2 to pi. And third quadrant is pi to 3 by 2. And fourth quadrant is 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi. 2 pi. One complete rotation is divided by 4 equal parts. That is, first part is 0 to pi by 2 is first quadrant, and pi by 2 to pi is second quadrant, and pi to 3 by 2 is third quadrant, and 3 by 2 to 2 by is fourth quadrant. Okay. Here, sine of trigonometric function. The trigonometric function is, you know, sine x, cos x, tan x, cosecant x, secant x, cot x. Okay, right. Simply call A. That means all A. Next, yes. And T. C. What's that? A, S, T, C. That is, A means all trigonometric ratios. All trigonometric ratios. A is all trigonometric function or ratios. That is, sine x, cos x, tan x, cosecant x, secant x, and cot x is also positive. Also positive. First quadrant, angle is first quadrant, then the ratios of trigonometric ratios are trigonometric function. Sine x, cos x are all positive. All are positive. All are positive. Second one, yes. Yes is called sine and its reciprocal cosecant. Sine value and its reciprocal value cosecant. Only positive. Only positive. Others mean cos is reciprocal and tan is reciprocal is negative. Other trigonometric ratios function is negative. Okay. First question, A is called all trigonometric value or trigonometric function is positive. Functions are positive. First one. And second question, yes. Yes is called sine and its reciprocal cosecant value only positive. But other trigonometric ratios, they want functions tan is reciprocal and cos is reciprocal. Negative means second quadrant. Second quadrant limit pi by 2 to pi. Okay? Right. Next. Third quadrant. For T. T is tan is reciprocal. Tan and its reciprocal cos. and its reciprocal cos are all positive. Otherwise, other denominator ratios, other denominator ratios are negative. Okay, next fourth one, C. C is called cos and its reciprocal value secant. Only positive. Others mean here sin is reciprocal and tan is reciprocal. Others are negative. Okay. Simply write sin of trigonometric functions. Sin of trigonometric functions. First of all, you know quadrants. Quadrants mean first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. First quadrant limit is 0 to pi by 2. And second quarter limit is pi by 2 to pi. And third quarter limit is pi to 3 by 2. And fourth quarter is 3 by 2 to 2 pi. 3 by 2 to 2 pi. Okay. Here sine of denominator ratios. Okay. Because shortly, ASTC. That is short term, all silver tea coffee. We can consider. Okay. All silver tea, coffee or cup. First letter. A mean all. Silver mean sine is sine and reciprocal. Tan and T. First letter T. And C cup or coffee. All silver tea, coffee. All silver tea, coffee. Okay. Right. Is all denominator ratios. All denominator ratios. Here first quadrant is called all denominator ratios is positive. All denominator ratios are positive. Second quadrant, sine is reciprocal, cosecant only positive, otherwise negative. And third quadrant, tan is reciprocal, cot only positive, otherwise negative. And fourth quadrant, cos and its reciprocal secant only positive, other denominator ratios are negative in fourth quadrant. Okay, right. Next, that is, we write sine, cos, tan, cosecant, secant, cot. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. What's that? Same one. First quadrant, all are positive, plus. Okay, that is all silver tea coffee number. I mean all silver tea coffee number. Okay, first quadrant, all denominator ratios are positive. Okay, right. Second quadrant, yes is mean sine is reciprocal. Sine is reciprocal, cosecant. Sine positive and cosecant positive. Otherwise negative. Okay, right. Third quadrant, tan is reciprocal. Yeah, tan is positive and tan is reciprocal, cot is positive, otherwise negative. Right, fourth quadrant, cos is reciprocal is positive, here cos is positive, and next cos is reciprocal, secant is positive, remaining for all negative. Okay, right, that's all. This is sign of denominator function. Very important, this is calculated. Okay, right. Next. Right. Next topic. Domain and the range of trigonometric function. Domain and the range of trigonometric function. First of all, trigonometric parameters and trigonometric identities, values of trigonometric ratios, and sign of trigonometric function are completed. Next, last one topic. domain and the range of erotic function. And erotic functions are sin x, cos x, tan x, cosecant x, secant x, cot x. Next, domain and range of erotic function. Sin x is called domain. What's with domain? Which value of x? Now substitute which value of x. Then the function sin x is satisfied. The function sin x is satisfied. This is called domain. This is called domain. Here sin x. Here x is any value, any real number. X have any real. You have substitute any real number. Sin x is defined answers only. Defined answers only. So x is belongs to R. Sin x and its domain is x is belongs to R. R means set of all real numbers. R means caps R. Set of all real numbers. The domain of sin x is belongs to R. Set of all real number. That is for x is belongs to open interval minus infinite comma plus infinite. Open interval means except endpoints. Okay, right. Then range of sin x. Range of sin x is minus 1 to plus 1. That is close interval of minus 1 comma plus 1. Close interval of minus 1 comma plus 1. Have any value next is equal to, then the value of sin x is only minus 1 to plus 1 value. Minus 1 to plus 1 value. So the range of this function sin x is minus 1 comma plus 1. This is close interval. Minus 1 less than or equal to. Less than or equal to close interval. Including endpoints. Including endpoint. That is sin pi by 12 1. So including endpoint. Sin 3 by 12 minus 1. So minus 1 is one of value of sin. Okay. Range is in a range city. Range mean the value of this function. Domain city is we have any value of this x value. But range is value of this function sin x. For sin x value only have minus 1 to plus 1 close interval. So domain of sin x is x is belongs to R and range of sin x is close interval minus 1 comma plus 1. Okay? Right. Next, a domain of cos x. Domain of cos x. Here is same. X is belongs to R. It's a substitute any real number, set of all any real number. Then cos x is equal to minus 1 to plus 1 value. Minus 1 to plus 1. That is close interval minus 1 comma plus 1. That is close interval minus 1 comma plus 1. Same. Sin x cos x domain interval is same. Okay. Right, next one. Tan x. Tan x and its domain. Domain of tan x is x is belongs to R minus 2n plus 1 of pi by 2. What's that? R minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. That means x is belongs to R, but x is not equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. That is odd multiple of pi by 2. Or multiple of pi by 2. That is tan x value odd multiple of pi by 2 is not defined. That's the tan pi by 2. Tan pi by 2 is not defined. Tan pi by 2 is not defined. And n equal to 0 is tan pi by 2. Okay? Actually, n equal to 1. N equal 1 means 1, 2 plus 2, 2 plus 1, 3. 3 pi by 2. But tan 3 pi by 2. Is that the same infinite? Tan 3 by 2 is infinite, not defined. So, all multiple of pi by 2. Domain of tan x is equal to x is belongs to set of all real numbers except all multiple of pi by 2. Except R multiple of pi by 2. That is denote x is belongs to R minus 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. So n is belongs to integer. So domain of tan x, function tan x is belongs to R minus 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. That's mean set of all real numbers except or multiple of pi by 2. Except or multiple of pi by 2. Okay. The range set of Nx. Range is minus infinity plus. That is mean tan x is belongs to set of all real numbers. Set of all real numbers. Okay. Right. Next. The domain of cosecant x. Domain of cosecant x is x is belongs to or minus n pi. That is x is set of all real number except n pi. It is belongs to integer. It is belongs to integer. What's that? Cosecant pi. Cosecant pi. Pi is not defined. Not defined. That is n equal to pi. Cosecant 0 value is not defined. Cosecant 2 pi is not defined. Why is that? Cosecant x is equal to 1 pi sin x. Here sin x is not equal to 0. But it's n pi. X is belongs to n pi. Sin x is always 0. So cosecant x is not defined. And x is belongs to n pi. So domain value of cosecant x is x is belongs to all minus n pi, n is belongs to z. Okay? Right, next. Range set of cosecant x. Range of cosecant x. Cosecant x is greater than or equal to 1. Cosecant x is greater than or equal to 1. And cosecant x is less than or equal to minus 1. Greater than or equal to plus 1. Listen carefully. Cosecant x is greater than or equal to plus 1. Cosecant x is less than or equal to minus 1. Cosecant x is less than or equal to minus 1. Okay? Right. Next one. Domain of secant x. Domain of secant x. Now x is belongs to set of all real numbers. The domain is x is belongs to set of all real numbers except or multiple of pi by 2. Except or multiple of pi by 2, n is belongs to z. What's that? Secant x. Secant x is equal to reciprocal of cos x. Secant x means 1 by cos x. 1 by cos x. Here cos x is not equal to 0. Cos x is not equal to 0, then secant x is defined. Suppose cos x equal to 0, here secant x value is not defined. So x is not equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. So x is not equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. That is denoted the domain of secant x is belongs to or minus 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. It is n belongs to z. N belongs to z. Okay. Next, a range set of secant x. Range set of secant x. Any real number. Secant x belongs to all real numbers. All values. Okay. Right, next one. Cortex. So cortex, domain of cortex. X is belongs to set of all real number except n pi. That's right. Cortex equal to cos x by sin x. Here sin x is not equal to 0. Why? Sin is denominator 0, that is not defined. So sin x is not equal to 0 is correct. Suppose sin x value is 0, then cot value is not defined. So cos x by sin x, sin x is not equal to 0. So x is not less to n pi. It is not equal to n pi. It is denoted to x is less to or minus n pi, n is less to z. Or minus n pi, n is belongs to z. Okay? Right, range set of cortex is any real number. Is any real number. Okay? Very, very important. Okay? Listen carefully. Right. Sin x, cos x, tan x, once again. Now, cosecant x, secant x, cortex. Domain and range. Okay? Right. Next. One simple formula. Sin and cos and secant. This is sin 2 pi plus x, cos 2 pi plus x, tan 2 pi plus x, plus sin 2 pi plus x. 2n pi, okay? 2 pi is sorry, 2 pi plus x is equal to sin x. Is equal to sin x. Cos 2 pi plus x equal to cos x. Tan 2 pi plus x equal to tan x. And cosecant 2 pi plus x equal to cosecant x. And secant 2 pi plus x equal to secant x. And cot 2 pi plus x equal to cot x. Why sir? Here 2 pi plus x. Then 2 pi plus x. That is 2 pi plus x is which quadrant of the same 2 pi plus x? First one. First pattern, second pattern, third pattern, fourth pattern. Already you know, sign of the number functions are there. Study in the last class. Here 2 pi plus x. 2 pi plus x is one single rotation is 2 pi. One single rotation is 2 pi. Then 2 pi plus x is first pattern. 2 pi plus x is first pattern. This is 2 pi plus x. 2 pi plus x. So 2 pi plus x is represented in first quadrant. 2 pi plus x is represented in first quadrant. So sine of 2 pi plus x, cos of 2 pi plus x, tan of 2 pi plus x, cosine of 2 pi plus x, and secant of 2 pi plus x, cot of 2 pi plus x is same. Sin x equal to sine of 2 pi plus x. Cos 2 pi plus x equal to cos x. And tan 2 pi plus x is tan x. And cosecant 2 pi plus x, cosecant x. Secant 2 pi plus x, secant x. Cot 2 pi plus x, cot x. Okay, right. Next one, important note. Negative angle of sine of the exercise. That means sine of minus x, cos of minus x, tan of minus x, cosecant of minus x, and secant of minus x. Last one, cot of minus x. Minus x. So minus x is representing fourth quadrant. Why is that? Minus x is a direction. Initial side two terminals in direction is clockwise. That is minus x. This is minus x. Okay. This direction is clockwise. So here angle is negative for minus x. Minus x. A minus x is representing fourth quadrant. Minus x is representing fourth quadrant. 2 pi plus x is first quadrant and minus x representing fourth quadrant. And then you know, fourth quadrant only cos x and its reciprocal secant x only possible. So cos of minus x is cos x positive and secant of minus x is secant x. Other dynamic ratios and fourth quadrant is negative. So secant of minus x, sine of minus x is minus sine x, and tan of minus x is minus tan x, cosecant of minus x is minus cosecant x, and cot of minus x is minus cot x. Okay, here minus x is representing fourth quadrant only cos and cos of reciprocal secant only positive. So cos of minus x is plus cos x, and secant of minus x is plus secant x. Otherwise sine of minus x minus sine x, and tan of minus tan x, cot of minus x is minus cot x. Okay, right. Next, the curves of y equal sine x, y equal cos. Okay, right. Okay, continuous topics in next class, is it? Next class. Okay, so this topic today, teaching topic is very important. Once more, you are learning the books, the topic introduction, and classes again, repeats. Concentrate on this topic, okay? Thank you. Bye.